Good evening. South Australia is now in the midst of a COVID outbreak, a school reunion becoming a super spreader event, reaching even the highest corridors of power.
The state's governor is tonight in isolation, the opposition leader too, but there are concerns about how South Australians are supposed to find out whether or not they've been exposed, with a change in the approach from SA Health causing confusion today.
COVID positive and entering Toms Court Medi Hotel quarantine. Among them, former Premier Jay Weatherill, who contracted COVID at a school reunion in Norwood, a cluster with 16 new cases today.
All of those cases will have quite a number of people that they've been in close contact with. So this is a lot of work for our team to do.
Two interstate arrivals have also tested positive, and so far, 210 close contacts identified. The opposition leader, one of two parliamentarians exposed, after coffee with Mr. Weatherill on Monday. He's returned a negative test, but by midday today, still hadn't heard about his contact status from SA Health.
You know, had Jay Weatherill not been such a high public profile figure, which resulted in media reports, I would actually be none the wiser, and that is a little worrying.
SA Health now asking people who test positive to help alert those they've been in contact with because of the time it will take them as case numbers grow.
And that means there may be some lag between you finding out because a friend's told you or a contact's told you and us getting hold of you.
Health authorities changing the way they inform the public about cases, which means some exposure sites won't be publicly revealed, like two hospitals impacted today but deemed no public risk.
So in the cases of the hospitals, it was contained, and so we've already done the contact tracing, so all of those people know.
We do know one positive case is a teacher at Taparoo's Ocean View College who was there on a pupil-free day.
It looks like a fair few of our staff are going to be impacted as close contacts, which means we're going to have to flip to an online learning environment for next week.
Parliament also suspended this morning until given the green light to resume this afternoon. The Premier says it was all inevitable.
We've got this. We've worked very hard to make sure that we were COVID ready before we opened the borders.
Health authorities are still investigating the source of the Norwood cluster. They're assuming it's come from an attendee from New South Wales, but because our borders are now open, it could also be a local infection which hadn't been detected. Now, Peter Malinauskas has informed me he finally received notification from SA Health that he's a close contact this afternoon. And we did attempt to speak with Jay Weatherill today, but he said he was not well enough to record an interview. And we hope he, like everyone now battling this virus, gets better quickly. Guys?
Absolutely. Thank you, Harvey. And Ella Duffy is live at Victoria Park. Ella, authorities have been forced to increase testing capacity.
Kate, they have, and it seems to have had an impact. We are seeing a steady stream of people arrive here at Victoria Park to get tested, but they are being processed relatively quickly. It was a much different story last night, though, as hundreds queued to get swabbed. Wait times blowing out following confirmation that there had been cases of community transmission here. Some were in line here at Victoria Park for more than 3.5 hours. SA Health says that yesterday more than 8,600 swabs were processed.
I imagine that quite a number of those will be people that have come from interstate, and I really just want to get the message across to all South Australians who haven't travelled, you're going to have to really start thinking about getting tested if you have any mild respiratory symptoms.
Now, there is a change to how our testing is being done. Our Chief Public Health Officer says that SA Pathology is now working to implement technology that will allow them to rapidly detect if any of our new cases are of the Omicron variant. Brenton?
Thank you, Ella. And there are changes at our borders tonight to try to stop that Omicron variant getting in at all after New South Wales recorded a seventh case of the new strain. Cam Inglis is at the airport. And Cam, our health authorities have decided to take action.
Yeah, Brenton, any traveller arriving from New South Wales will need to get a COVID test upon entering South Australia. This is because international arrivals landing at Sydney Airport only need to isolate for 72 hours. And with hundreds of Omicron cases popping up across the globe, our health authorities believe the risk was simply too great. They admit they still don't know much about the new COVID strain, but they're hoping the new testing requirement will provide an extra layer of protection. And the police commissioner says there'll also be more scrutiny at the border to stop people coming in from interstate quarantine-free without declaring they've been overseas.
We are concerned that even though we require people to disclose their travel status as they come into South Australia, it may be something that is overlooked or not disclosed, and that creates a risk for us, and we're watching that very closely.
And while we are watching New South Wales, Western Australia is watching us. Their Premier says it's likely that the border will soon be shut off to South Australia, but tonight he is waiting on health advice. Kate?
Cam, thank you.